As the 1905 revolution began, Nicholas was wondering on how to suppress the revolution. Sergei gave him an idea. Sergei knew that the farmers, liberals, and workers weren't working together for their demands. He knew that there was a weakness to exploit. For the liberals, Sergei wrote a manifesto and requested Nicholas to establish a legislative body called the Duma, where Nicholas would choose the representatives. At first, Nicholas didn't want to share his power, but he then decided to share his power. With this, the liberals had their demand. Nicholas then ended the war with Japan and suppressed the farmers and the workers, and as a result, there were no protests. After doing this, Nicholas then dissolved the Duma as he had the power to do so. With this, Nicholas II survived the 1905 revolution as he outplayed the Russian people. After the 1905 revolution, the Tsar's next advisor was Pyotr Stolypin. To avoid such a revolution in the future, Stolypin used to suppress harder on the Tsar's opponents. Despite this, he also reformed agriculture, gave freedom of speech, and right to vote. These reforms were written in Russia's constitution in 1906. As a result, Russia's economy began to improve. It was during this time that Nicholas met a strange person named Rasputin. Rasputin was born in 1869 at a small village in Siberia to a peasant family. He could have lived a normal life in his village, but in the 1890s, he converted to the Russian Orthodox Church. He was inspired by monks and used to move from one holy site to another holy site. As he spent years on pilgrimages across Russia, his popularity in the empire grew. Some even believed that he had mystical powers in prediction and healing. As he reached St. Petersburg, he won the favor of being the family spiritual advisor. Tsar Nicholas's son, Alexei, had a blood disease named hemophilia. When Alexei had a medical crisis in 1912, Rasputin advised Tsar Nicholas to not take any treatment from doctors. As a result, Alexei's health improved, and with this, Rasputin was very close to the royal family and cemented the royal family's belief on him. But there were mixed views on Rasputin. The peasants thought that he was one of them and a representative of the peasants to the Tsar, whereas the nobles and the clergymen thought that he was a bad image to the Russian monarchy. At first, the media were banned from talking about Rasputin, but after the ban was lifted, the nobles and the clergymen were wondering that Rasputin was influencing the Tsar and his family. Nicholas could have spent his post-1905 revolution by improving his image. Instead, he added another confusion to his empire. But as the Russian economy was going well and the people were satisfied, Nicholas II probably could have been the great ruler of Russia, but one major event in the world broke his power completely. It was World War I. All without